First up, I want to introduce to you a very, very special friend of mine. She's amazing with all the work that she does. She runs Viva la Vegan. She's the president of the VBSQ Society here in Queensland. She's a great speaker. She travels the world. She writes books. She does blogs. She does pretty much everything that you can do. She's talking about etiquette online and how to deal with negative people online. Please give LC a huge round of applause.
So if you want to find out more about vegan health, We've got Kamina just over here. Give us a wave, Kamina. And to my mother, Amanda Bennett. Amanda is a registered vegan dietitian. And Kamina's actually a lifelong vegan. And her and her mum are going to give a food demo later this tonight. So I'd encourage people to see the people that have qualifications in these areas. Now, when I was a vegan, when I first became vegan 20 years ago, I went vegan because I found out that animals were dying and I was part of the reason they were dying. So I thought, wow, if I tell people about this, they're going to go vegan like me, aren't they? Obviously, hey. So I told everyone all the time, here's my family down here actually, so they can vouch for this even. So it's pretty hardcore about it. And, you know, I just tell people, oh, well, this is what happens with pigs, this is what happens with cows, this is what happens with chickens. And they go, oh, yeah. And that was about it. So I was very intent on telling everyone all this information that I knew about the vegan world and how that they could be saved. And became a bit of an evangelistical sort of spokesperson for a while. Now, this may not be the best way to do it. And I've learned that now. You know, get a bit older, get a bit more experienced in the movement, and you know that these sort of things don't help. They put off people, actually. And I know, for example, if someone tells me what to do or how to do it, I don't really like that. I like learning things, I like finding out my own information. So I encourage you just to plant seeds, not actually try and convert people. And you'd have to be aware too that not everyone cares about the same things that you do, okay? Just because you care about health, just because you care about the environment, just because you care about animals, does not mean other people do. And there's nothing wrong with that. That's okay. We're all different people, and we're just trying to get along and understand each other. And nowadays, I'm much more accepting about people. I'm trying to be non-judgmental, sometimes it works. And I'm also really good with time energy and with energy management and time management. And I just see sometimes the way people are interacting online or the way people are using their time and energy. And I don't want to be giving my precious time, my precious energy into these things that I don't necessarily see as positive things, especially with the movement. Years of being vegan, a lot of people ask me, can you give us some sort of advice? Can you give us like a tagline or something? And my best piece of advice is to lead by example and be consistent. I think it's pretty simple. So lead by example, be consistent. And I personally think that everyone is doing the best that they can in the best way they know how. And we all have different ways of doing okay. And I want all of us today to try and focus on being the best versions of ourselves that we can be. Learn more, learn some things today. Try and be the best version of yourself. And there's a lot of outrage at the moment. Every day, every hour, there's something else to be outraged about. And in person, okay? And you can disagree with someone, you can debate with someone, and you don't have to use name-calling or judgment or negative words. Might be hard for people to understand that sometimes, but it's actually doable. And you may be the only vegan that someone comes into contact with, okay? This is really important. Some people don't seem to care about this. But whether it's online or even in person, you might be the first vegan or the only vegan someone knows. And your interaction with them, or the way they see you interacting with other people, is very important because it can turn people off or it can draw them towards you or the movement more. Okay? So I've had so many people say to me, oh, I would have become vegan 10 years ago if it wasn't for this guy online who was acting rah-rah. So there's so many times I've heard that, okay? So just be mindful of that. And what you do and how you do it reflects the whole movement. So we really need to act like it, okay? I want to talk about some of my tips for online etiquette. Can anyone actually read this? No? It's in my lovely hand lettering here. I thought it would look very pretty tonight, so just pretend you can read it. I'll even read it out for you. Okay, so my number one tip, actually this is my number one tip just for life in general. Act, don't react. Okay? Act, don't react. And the difference is, sometimes you have to take a breath. Sometimes you have to count to 10. Sometimes I don't respond to an annoying email until the next day. When I'm calmed down, when I'm trying not to become emotional about it, I'm realizing that person's just asking a question. And that's what I'm trying to bring it down to. Pretend that I've never heard a question before because I've heard a lot of the same questions over and over for 20 years, okay? So pretend they're a new person, they're trying to learn stuff. Keep private matters private. If you have a problem with someone, message them privately. And actually, even better, see them in person. Hey, give a chat after. You know, I want to sort out that thing we were discussing. Many years ago that they're transferring over to online, so I found that direct lettering like me, and you use their content, you need to tag them or say, this is done by this person, or thanks so and so. And take responsibility for every single thing that you do online. Is that pretty easy? Do you think? Can everyone do those things starting here now? Yeah, I think so. I think they're quite achievable. I had some really good other quotes, but I might not get into them because we're a bit time poor today. But if you're wondering about online etiquette and you just want to go forward and tell someone something new, just means to be nice to people. Just means to be courteous. So encourage people to do that online. And I love words, I love reading, I love writing, and words are so powerful, okay? Just as words have the power to heal and to inspire people, they also have the power to really affect someone. So be really mindful of what you do and choose your words wisely. I just wanted to talk about what people share online. So for example, there's a lot of negative images or videos that people share online, and people always ask me this question, so that's why I thought I'd talk to you about it. I don't have a problem with people sharing negative images or negative videos as long as you follow it up with how they can actually help that. Because you don't want to overwhelm people with all the problems in the world, because there's a hell of a lot. We want to say, hey, here's an issue, but here's how you can help. Here's how we can, you know, be powerful and change some things. So if you have to share a video, need to say something at the end like, you can support these animals at Farm Animal Rescue, or you can support Sugar Shine Farm Sanctuary. You know, something like that. Something important for people to know. And if you have a lot of negativity online and you're following people, and every time you scan down your newsfeed, it's negative, negative, negative. You're allowed to actually unfriend people. You're allowed to actually block people. You're allowed to do that. There's nothing wrong with that. And just find a balance between the good stuff. Find more of the good stuff. And sometimes we really, really have to do a lot of searching for that. And you know, I say to people all the time, it's like music nowadays, or art or film. There's a lot of rubbish that a lot of people seem to be impressed with, or seem to buy, or seem to, it seems to be popular. But there's a hell of a lot of other stuff around. There's some really good gems that you can find if you actually search outside of the mainstream. So do that a bit. And, I want to talk a bit about emotions. How's everyone with their emotions? Who's a bit emotional? Who would say that they're an emotional person? Yeah. I know a lot of people who are, actually, to be honest. I'm pretty good with my emotions. And I want to talk about emotions and outrage, because people seem to get very caught up about that. Now, outrage in particular is what social media platforms love. They want us to interact with it. They want us to share it. They want us to engage with it. And why do you think this is? It gains more interest, yes. But also, it's because of revenue. They're making money. The more time we're on an app and we don't leave it, the more time every single thing we do goes through a particular app, then the longer we're staying on there and seeing their ads and buying from them, they're getting money. So keep these things in mind next time there's a next viral hashtag that's going around. And, you know, this, I was just reading lately, there's a couple of really good articles on Wired. Has anyone heard of Wired? It's a tech website that talks a lot about different technology things. So I'd suggest that to people if you've never heard of it. And all this time that we are online and we're outraged, these feelings are overwhelming. Every time you're going through your feed, you're like, outraged. I'm outraged about me too. I'm outraged about the animals. I'm outraged. outraged about Donald Trump, I'm outraged about the ridiculousness of the Australian political scene. You know, there's all these things to be outraged about, okay? And this completely exhausts us. Do you feel exhausted online? Like, you know, sometimes it's just like, wow, when is this going to stop? So, that actually is making us immune to actually act. Does everyone get that? This overwhelm that we're having is making us immune to actually do anything about it. And not only that, this study that I was reading recently, it showed that the more we have these expressions of outrage online, and the more that we're actually involved in this outrage, this is leading to less meaningful interaction and involvement in social causes. And that includes donating or volunteering your time to animal rights or vegan movements in particular, but not just limited to that, environmental movements, social justice, etc. So does everyone understand that? The more we're outraged, the more that we're involved in this outrage online, we're feeling as though we've done enough. We don't need to actually go out into the real world and actually do anything, which we do. Okay? So, let's think about some things about what we're doing now and how we're using our time online to be effective. Are we actually being effective? That's up to you to decide, okay? And is your interaction online, is the things you share and are the things that you're interacting and engaging with people, is it both based on emotions? Is it based on outrage? How many people would say it's based on emotion or outrage, what they're doing at the moment? Okay, so you're perfect. Don't know why you listen to me, but we'll keep going. And so, you know, there's a couple of things lately that I'm quite worried about in the world. You know, we're entertaining each other instead of engaging with each other and exchanging ideas. We're searching for approval instead of searching for knowledge. And we're searching, we're exchanging images instead of exchanging ideas. And I just think instead of talking to, we need to be talking to each other more instead of just trying to focus on entertaining each other. And I really don't want to be like that. Does anyone else want to be like that? It seems pretty boring, doesn't it? You know? And I just worry that people aren't their true selves and that no one gets to know them. And this is the thing with me. I've had quite a few trolls over the years. And a lot of people say to me, how do you not interact with people? How do you not get upset? Or why don't you do this? Or you should do that. And for me, it comes down to, especially if I've known someone, or they think they know me. There's only a certain amount of people in my life who actually know me. So for other people to have an opinion about me, I don't really care, because they didn't know me. They just see whatever they want, the blogs or the videos or the talks, and they assume what they like about me. And that's fine. If you've got an opinion on who you think I am, go for it. But only a few people know who I am, and they're the people I care about, their opinion. And so with people and dealing with people online, if you've actually seen someone, how many people have run pages or deal with trolls? Quite a lot, okay. So if you think about people being negative towards a page or towards you, so if you know this person and you know the way the interaction is, I would suggest you just don't deal with them. Don't engage, block them, don't do anything. Simple. But for people that you don't know, who are just new to your page or new to interacting with you, just try and think first off. They're just asking a question. They're just being inquisitive. Then respond. Just simply, sometimes all I'll say is thanks for the feedback. Or thanks for your opinion. You don't need to get, some people will send me very long responses or very long emails, and I'll just say thanks for letting me know. Because I personally don't have time to get into the back and forth that anything else would give. And when you've done that with someone, you say, okay, thanks for your opinion, or you just answered their question, for example, and they keep going or they keep actually trolling you, and then you don't have to call them. So that would be a big tip with that. And so I want us also to think about what language we use online, because I've seen a lot of examples of people not being very nice to people online. So I want you to think about this today and have a look online as well, where other people are doing things. Are you using positive language or are you using negative language? Are you using encouraging words or discouraging words? Are you being empathetic or are you being judgmental? Are you preaching or are you teaching? And in particular, is your language racist? Could it offend someone? And we don't have to put other social justice movements or other people off just to promote veganism. A lot of people get confused about that. We can still promote veganism, we can still promote animal rights, and still be kind to other people, and still be compassionate to other movements. And when I'm talking about racist language, there's some really good examples. Like, have you seen the way people speak about Japanese people in regards to whaling, or Middle Eastern people in regards to live export? Or even recently Balinese people in regards to the dog meat trade. It's pretty horrible, I think, and that's not a good way to act. What about trigger words? Does anyone know what a trigger word means? Just means something that would trigger a certain response in someone that you can't control, that you don't know what it's going to be. So trigger words would be slave, rape, concentration camp. How many of you have heard any of those phrases or words being used to promote veganism? What about, do you give unsolicited health advice? I've seen a lot of people. Veganism can cure people, you know? Can cure a lot of things, but you know, we all still are going to die. Sorry to tell you.
Thank you.
say to people is, why do you think trolls are trolls? Why do you think they do these things to you? Does anyone feel about that? I think about these things, you know? And I like to try and be empathetic, and I am, you know, towards people who say certain things to me. I show empathy and I show compassion to them because I know that the problem is with them. You know, there's a lot of people who have a lot of problems in their life, and I'm doing that way. There's a lot of things in the world that can get me down. And some people handle that better than other people, okay? My life's pretty awesome. I'm doing the things I want to do. I'm working on the things I want to do. A lot of people don't seem to think they can do that. So just keep these things in mind, that it's not about you and people are being mean to you. It's about them. And hopefully that can help you not get too emotionally involved and not react to what they're saying. And like I said before, if you can get someone and have a talk to them offline and say, hey, what you said to me, I really don't understand what you're saying. I thought we were friends, I thought we both agreed. Try and take it offline if you can. And don't feed the trolls. Has everyone heard that? Have you heard that saying? Do not feed the trolls. And that's because a lot of trolls thrive on that. They thrive on you coming back to them and, oh my God, I can't wait to get home to see what that said to me. I'm going to say this back to them. So many people love that. So we're not going to feed that, okay? And just remember, like when I first became vegan, okay, I just wanted to be friends with people who were vegan. That was it. I just really wanted to be around vegan people because 20 years ago there wasn't many people, let's be honest. And, a little vegan tribe. I put on Australia's first vegan festival in 2010-2011 with a not-for-profit called Green Earth Group. And around that time, I was dating someone who was very not suited to me, and I craved something more. I craved, intellectually stimulating conversation. So I went to find like-minded people for this. And that's when I created my vegan tribe. And I didn't really do too much, I wasn't very discerning about the types of vegan planogram, let's just say that. So it took me a few years, some places, to work out, hey, that person's a bit racist, or that person doesn't really agree with women's rights or some social justice issues that I have problems with. So, you know, I got rid of those people over time, and now I have awesome friends and positive people in my life that I actually like hanging around. So I would suggest this to people. If you're already a new vegan, definitely go out and meet as many people as you can. Chat to people here, join some groups, go to some new events, and you don't have to be friends with everyone. And it's okay to be, I get a bad feeling about that person, I'm not going to give them any more of my time. It's okay.
house.
And, you know, people don't like to hear that, but it's true. Sleep well, exercise well, exercise in particular outside is awesome. Eat well, be grateful. Being grateful is really awesome, and I really encourage people to, you know, if you get a great pup, thank you. You can say thank you, universe, or whatever, you know. But just say thanks for the good things. And I always end the day with thanks, universe, for this, 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 this. And it always makes me get in the moment and realize that I actually had a pretty good day, or at least there was one good thing about my day. Sometimes it feels hard, but you're like, oh, that's a really good conversation, you know, or something, you know. Try and focus on the positive things in your life. So go outside more. How many people work in the office or a computer all the time? Me too. I'm always on the computer. And they say that it's just as bad as smoking now. So we all think we're healthy and we're just for vegan diet and pizza, we're just sitting on a computer all the time. And they're gaining all your great benefits. So try and get out and do some outside activities. I love swimming. That's my thing. I love swimming. Be inspired by people. So find someone or something that makes you feel inspired. Music, books, art, people. There's so many inspirational people in the world if you're willing to look. Be creative. One of my favourite things is travel. So I've just come back from Europe for 3 months and Indonesia for a month. I love to travel. I work for myself so I can do it. And I really encourage people to travel more. And in particular, solo travel. And I saw things from afar, you know, and I made some really big decisions just recently when I traveled. buy them online. And if you've learned something today that you didn't know before, I'd really like for you to share that with someone else as well. Because that's really important, sharing information. I'm filming all the videos from tonight, so you can watch this later and you can watch all the other speakers as well. And then do you